Hi everyone, I'm Cristina. In this video, we'll see a way to hide processes from Task Manager by manipulating the user interface. Windows is an event-driven operating system. The applications communicate between them using events and commands. In this episode, we'll see how this can be abused to manipulate GUI elements from a different process. Let's get started. This is actually not something completely new. A similar technique existed for previous versions of Windows. Although not very popular, it was seen to be used by some in the wild malware. We'll create a modified version of this technique that works for Windows 8.1 and above on 64-bit platforms. Before we begin, let's do a bit of exploration using WinSpy++ tool to understand Windows elements. Let's say, for example, that we want to examine the Windows Task Manager built-in application. We want to understand where it is and how to interact with the process list. In WinSpy, drag the target icon over the element to be examined. In the General tab, we have information about the controls. In this case, a list view. And there is more. Like, for example, the style of the control and various other properties. Very important, we also have the relationships between this class and its siblings and parent window. To make things even easier, there is this more button here. We need first the PID of the task manager process. We could use another tool like Process Explorer or just search it here. Okay, this is the one, 7120. Select and expand process 7120 in WinSpy. Here we have the whole hierarchy of elements from Task Manager UI. Drill down to explore all the elements. Some of those elements are sys_list_view elements, exactly what we want to modify. Good. Let's take this one for example. Basically, these two lists represent the process list and the services list. For the sake of this demonstration, we'll attempt to hide an element from the process list. For this to be effective, we first need to make sure that the process list will not update. Because if it does, hiding a process doesn't make much sense. We also need to remove the refresh option. So, we have the plan. Let's discuss a few caveats. Windows Vista and 2008 introduced something called User Interface Privilege Isolation, UIPI. This prevents lower integrity processes to send certain commands to higher integrity processes. Some of our commands are affected, so we'll deal with this later. Another important aspect. It's not that easy to read a list's elements from another process. We'll need to do a workaround. We will write and then read the memory of the target process. Task manager, We'll come back to this idea. Keep this in mind as we go through the source code. To read memory from 64-bit processes, our program should be 64-bit as well. You guessed right. Otherwise, we risk running into a lot of trouble. Source code is available on the referenced GitHub link. Let's have a look at the code. So, don't miss the GitHub also. First, we want to identify the window elements of Task Manager. Then we will disable the process updates. We do this by simulating mouse clicks on the view menu. Then we go to update speed and simulate another click on the paused option. There you go. Finally, we will disable the refresh now option. This is the code for the first stage, the preparation phase. In the next stage, we retrieve the list of all the processes using the memory injection trick mentioned above, Then search for a name given from the command line, and finally remove the element from the list. Here's the tricky part, retrieving the process list into the memory of the target process. This can be done by dynamically allocating memory inside Task Manager process. Then read the list of processes using the inter-Windows send message API. The block is created using virtual alloc EX. We will then read from that block using read process memory API call. At this point, we will parse that list, identify the one to hide, and just delete that element from the list by passing the command lvm delete item. Let's see what happens. Remember UIPI, User Interface Privilege Isolation? Now it comes into action. Let's see what happens, and specifically the privileges of our program, if we run it as usual. We'll use Process Explorer to examine the integrity level of our process and the target process. For this, we need to add a new column, which is not present by default. Select Columns, Process Image tab, then select Integrity Level. Notice that our Task Manager runs with Integrity Level High. Visual Studio runs with Integrity Level Medium, similarly with almost all other user processes. If we were to open a command prompt, it would also run with medium integrity level. Let's just keep this in mind for now. Okay, let's compile the program, as we said, as a 64-bit application. Then navigate to the output folder in a terminal. Let's see what we have here. Right. Great. To test it, we want to hide notepad process. We could choose any other process you guys want. Doesn't really matter. So notepad for now. We actually have two processes, but only need one of them for this demo. So we terminate the second one. Run the application and provide the name of the process to hide as an argument there. The tool finds all the correct handles to the task manager window, to the view and update menus. Unfortunately, the message we tried to send to the task manager process got blocked. So, what happens? Remember UIPI, user interface privilege isolation? The error comes from this portion of the code, where we try to obtain the ID of the update menu. Right, the target application doesn't want to respond to that message, unfortunately, for us. But, even though send message doesn't return an error code, our message is silently discarded. Next, let's try the same thing from a console with administrative privileges. Let's verify privileges in Process Explorer. Now the console is running at high integrity level, same as Task Manager. Right, rerun and see what happens. Here, good. Let's also confirm that all the menus are visible in Task Manager and Notepad process is displayed. There we have it. It seems that everything went okay. The refresh option and the update menu should be disabled. Let's confirm that in the Task Manager interface. Right. So no refresh now option and no update speed menu either. That's exactly what we wanted. Notepad process also disappeared from the processes list. As we can see there, are no new live updates to the processes list. In the output of our program, we see all the processes have been enumerated until Notepad was found. Then we simply detached it from the list, and now it's gone. The same technique can be used to hide services, registry keys, or anything else that could be manipulated via the UI, user interface. Great. We can actually play with the services list now, as we may want to restore the default settings that we changed to hide our process. Let's see. Code modifications are pretty straightforward. Task Manager UI has two elements of type sysListView. One is the processes list, and the other one is for the services. We iterated through the list and checked each element one by one. The loop exists at the first one, which is the process list, with the return statement. Right. The second list is for the services, as we said, and let's use WinSpy to verify also this. Play a bit with the tool, just to get comfortable with the hierarchy display of controls. Here. Play a little bit, just for fun. The process ID of Task Manager is different since we restarted it, but it doesn't bother us so much. The new one is 6056. Drill down and check the child windows. Right. The very last element over here is the list of services. Make a note of its handle. We'll use it later on. To hide a service, we'll modify the code and then recompile it. So, just rebuild the solution. There we have it. In the same console, say that we want to hide the ALG service, right? These two lists we talk about here, if you're curious, double check their handles with WinSpy. The same procedure of disabling the updates is applied. Then enumerate the services. We found 180 of them and we stopped after the one to be hidden. The ALG service is now gone. We can notice. Right. Let's check our notes. Exactly the same trick can be used with Windows RegEdit tool or other monitoring tools for that matter. So guys, to recap, in this video, we learned how to manipulate elements from the user interface of other processes. Remember, this is just a technique which is neither inherently good nor bad. It depends, in essence, how you use it. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe and send us your feedback. Cheers!